Welcome back to Google class. Dear students, how are you? Today I am going to take class Transfer of Property Act under section Rights and Liabilities of the Lease. So let's see. Rights and Liabilities of the Lessee under chapter Lease, but Liabilities of the Lessee. Okay. Section E, 108 subclause E, explain about the Bar Act. If by fire, tempest or flood or violence of an army or of a mob or other irresistible force, any material part of the property be wholly destroyed or rendered substantially and permanently unfit for the purpose for which it was let, the lease shall, at the option of the lessee, be void. Okay, provided that if the injury be occasioned by the wrongful act or default of the lessee, he shall not be entitled to avail himself of the benefit of this provision. Okay, and clearly indicated the rights of the lessee, 108 subclause E to 108 subclause J. Okay, both the rights and liabilities of lessee can be rights following. Number one, lessee right to enjoy the accretions. Number two, lessee right to avoid the lease in case of any destruction by fire, tempest, etc. Number three, right to repair the property when lessor fails to do so and to deduct the cost of repairs from rent. Number four, right to make such payments, which are obligatory on the lessor, and to deduct the that amount from rent. Number five, right to remove the fixing any of the lands, fixtures made by him during tenancy. Number six, right to have the benefit of crops, C-R-O-P-S, crops growing on the land sown or planted by him. Number seven, right to assign his interest in the leased property. Okay, let's discuss about briefly under section 108 subclause E. Explain to avoid the lease in the case of destruction, etc. The class has no reference to the case of the property becoming unprofitable. Here, a lessee is not responsible for the consequences of fire unless he had definitely taken the burden upon his shoulders by his covenant. That means agreement between both parties, or unless negligence is proved against him, the lease does not become ipso facto void, but becomes voidable at the option of the tenant, and on that option being exercised, it becomes void. Okay, and another thing, section 108 subclause F explain about the Bar Act. If the lessor neglects to make within a reasonable time after notice any repairs which he is bound to make to the property, the lessee may make the same himself and deduct the expense of such repairs with interest from the rent, or otherwise recover it from the lessor. Okay, this class F explain that to repair in default of the lessor. Now note down, to repair in default of the lessor, there is no general rule of law that a lessor is bound to keep the demised property in good repair or to expend any money on the property, neither under this clause nor under clause subclause M, it is competent for the lessee or lessor, as the case may be, to compel rebuilding or reconstruction. Okay, on the basis, the lessee can deduct from rent expenses of only those repairs, not all, which the landlord was bound to execute either by an express stipulation in the lease or on account of local usage. But the lessee must first give notice to the lessor to do the repairs before he can make the repairs himself. Okay. And another thing, in the absence of contract to the contrary, the lessee is not entitled to call upon the lessor to repair the property. The Act clearly imposes no obligation on the landlord to repair. On the contrary, a qualified obligation in that respect lies on the lease under clause subclause M. Further, the lease is not entitled to recover any compensation for loss suffered by him due to lessor's future repair. Okay. And section 108 subclause G explain about the Bar Act. The lessor neglects to make any payment which he is bound to make, and which, if not made by him, is recoverable from the lessee or against the property, the lessee may make such payment himself and deduct it with interest from the rent, otherwise recover it from the lessor. And this clause, subclause G, explained about deduction of taxes. Okay, deduction of taxes. Here, generally, that a tenant is not entitled to claim adjustment of all payments made by him on behalf of the landlord, even though he is interested in such payment against rent payable by him. A rent may sue the landlord for reimbursement of the money which he had paid in order to save his own interest, and may recover the money so paid. In order to entitle a tenant to claim adjustment of such payment against rent payable by him, something more is required, namely some sort of contract or understanding that such payment shall be adjusted against rent account. Such adjustment cannot be made by the tenant alone without the concurrence of the landlord. Okay. Section 108 subclause H explain about the lessee may, even after the determination of the lease, remove at any time whilst he is in the possession of the property leased, but not afterwards, all things which he has attached to the hearth, provided he leaves the property in the state in which he received it. This is what saying clause H. So section 108 clause H explain about removal of fixtures. Removal of fixtures. A lease under this clause is entitled to remove any trees or fixtures planted or set up by him on the leased property. Prior to the amendment, the lessee could remove them at any time during the continuance of the lease. And nothing was said as to the rights of the parties in respect of such things after the determination of the lease, if they had not already been removed by the lessee. This gave rise to conflict of decision as to when and how far the tenants should be allowed to remove them after the determination of the lease. The amendment made by Amendment Act 20 of 1929 now allows him to remove them so long as he is in possession of the property, even though the tenancy has come to an end. But while removing these fixtures, he must see that the property is left in the same condition in which he has received it. Where the landlord makes use of materials of any superstructure, the tenant is entitled to recover the value thereof. A trespasser cannot claim compensation for the trees planted by him. Okay, section 108 subclause I explain about the Borrower Act. When a lease of uncertain duration determination by any means except the fault of the lessee, he or his legal representative is entitled to all the crops planted or sown by the lessee and growing upon the property when the lease determines, and to free ingress and egress together and carry them. Okay, this class I means 108 subclause I explain about to remove the crops. This clause enacts in substance the principles of common law of England and of what was also the law of India. Similarly, a lessee has right to remove the crops after the termination of the lease on any count excepting by his own default, and for the purpose he is entitled to have a free ingress to and egress from the property. This clause applies to lessees of certain duration, such a lease from year to year, or terminable on the happening of some event. Okay, section 108 subclause J of the TP Act. The Borrower Act clearly explained the lessee may transfer absolutely by way of mortgage or sublease the whole or any part of his interest in the property, and any transferee of such interest or part may again transfer it. The lessee shall not, by reason only of such transfer, cease to be subject to any of the liabilities attaching to the lease. Okay, this clause 108 clause subclause J explain about right of transfer. Okay, this Bar Act explain about right of transfer. Class subclause J explain about right of transfer. The general provision of the law that the property of any kind may be transferred except as provided by this act or any other law for the time being in force applies to leasehold interest as well. A lease can also assign its interest in any lawful manner. Such interest being itself an immovable property can as such be validly assigned. Okay, for instance, he can validly transfer by sublease even a part of his interest in the property, but this right of lessee is not as much absolute as that of purchase of the property, in as much as it may be excluded altogether by the parties. Okay, the above all section and subclause, section 108 subclause E to subclause J, the rights of the Let's see. Okay. Above all, rights of the. Let's see. Section 108, subclause E, F, G, H, I, J. Up to J. From E to up to J. 108 of TP Act. Explain about rights of the lessee. Okay. Next, liabilities. Okay, students. We'll discuss this liabilities of lessee next video class. Okay. Thank you all. Bye.